morphology of chromosomes. The chromosomes are tiny, thread-like structures found in the nucleus of a cell. The chromosomes were first observed as rod-like structures in plant cells by Carl Wilhelm von Nageli in 1842. Strasburger in 1875 discovered thread-like structures which appeared during cell division. Walther Fleming in 1879 introduced the term chromatin to describe the thread-like material of the nucleus that became intensely colored after staining. The name chromosome was coined by German anatomist Waldier in 1888 for the darkly stained bodies of nucleus. In 1902, Sutton and Bowery suggested that the chromosomes were the physical structures which acted as messengers of heredity. Morgan, in 1933, discovered the function of chromosome in transmission of hereditary traits. Hence, chromosomes are commonly described as carriers of heredity. In viruses, the chromosomes occur as singly and chemically may contain either DNA or RNA. It is a distinguishing feature of viruses from all organisms which possess both DNA and RNA. DNA-containing viruses were called deoxyviruses and RNA-containing viruses as riboviruses. The DNA-containing viral chromosomes may be either of linear shape or of circular shape. The RNA-containing viral chromosomes are composed of a linear, single, stranded RNA molecule and occur in some animal viruses and some bacteriophages. Both types of viral chromosomes are either tightly packed within the capsids of mature virus particles or occur freely inside the host cell. In bacteria, the entire hereditary material is packed into a single irregularly folded compact mass called nucleoid or genophore. It is short and simple, consisting of a single DNA molecule. The DNA is in the form of a double helix, which forms a closed ring or circle with no free ends. It is permanently attached to a mesosome. The nucleoid has a very high DNA concentration, as well as containing all the proteins associated with DNA, such as polymerases, repressors, and others such as HU and HNS. In addition to the nucleoid, a bacterial cell may show the presence of extrachromosomal DNA molecules called plasmids. The plasmids mainly carry genes responsible for characteristics like fertility and antibiotic resistance. The plasmids can be easily isolated from or introduced into the bacterial cells. They can be integrated with desired genes and hence are of immense use in genetic engineering. Eukaryotic chromosomes. The eukaryotes usually contain much more genetic information than the viruses and prokaryotes. Therefore, they contain a great amount of genetic material, which may not occur as a single unit, but many units called chromosomes. Different species of eukaryotes have different but always constant and characteristic number of chromosomes. The eukaryotic chromosomes differ from the prokaryotic chromosomes in morphology, chemical composition, and molecular structure. The shape of eukaryotic chromosome is changeable from phase to phase in the continuous process of cell growth and cell division. They are thin, coiled, elastic, thread-like structures during the interphase and are called chromatin threads. The morphology of the chromosome is best studied during metaphase and anaphase, which are the periods of maximal contraction. During these phases, the chromatin threads become highly coiled and folded to form compact and individually distinct ribbon-shaped chromosomes. The number of chromosomes is fixed for a species. It varies from a minimum of 2 to several hundred in different species of plants and animals. All individuals of a given species show the same chromosome number in their body cells. The chromosome number of a given species is generally represented as the diploid number, since chromosomes occur in pairs. In some cases, the chromosome number will be haploid, indicating the presence of unpaired chromosomes. Haploid number is a characteristic feature of gametes, the sperm and the ovum in animals, or the gametophytic generation in plants. Haploid chromosome number may be seen in some adult organisms also. Male honeybees are haploid, that is monoploid, whereas females are diploid. In animals, the lowest number is found in Ascaris magocephala with a diploid number of 2, while the highest number of chromosomes is found in Radiolarian protozoan Alocantha with a diploid number of 1600. In case of plants, the lowest number is found in Mucorhemelis, a bread mold fungus, with a chromosome number of only 2, and the highest chromosome number has been recorded in Ophioglossum with a chromosome number of 1,262. In most organisms, chromosomes fall in the size range of 0.1 to 30 micrometer in length and 0.2 to 2 micrometer in thickness. In general, chromosomes are larger in size in plants than in animals. Among plants, monocots contain larger chromosomes than dicots. A chromosome is usually composed of following parts: pellicle and matrix, chromatid, chromonema, chromomeres, centromere, telomere, secondary construction, and satellite bodies. First, the pellicle and matrix. Each chromosome is apparently bounded by a thin membrane called pellicle. The pellicle encloses a jelly-like substance called matrix. Both the pellicle and matrix are composed of achromatic or non-genetic material and appear only at metaphase when the nucleolus disappears. It is believed that nucleolar material and matrix are interchangeable, that is, when matrix disappears, nucleolus appears, and vice versa. The true structure and function of pellicle and matrix are not known because they are not stainable with dyes. Most probably, the matrix aids in keeping the chromosomes within bounds. It may also serve as an insulating sheath for the genes during cell division. Number 2, chromatid. At metaphase, each chromosome consists of 2 symmetrical structures, the chromatids, each one of which contains a single DNA molecule. The chromatids are attached to each other only by the centromere and becomes separated at the start of anaphase when the sister chromatids migrate to opposite poles. Therefore, anaphase chromosomes have only 1 chromatid, while as metaphase chromosomes have 2. Now, the chromonemata. During prophase, the chromosomal material becomes visible as very thin filaments, which are called chromonemata and which represent chromatids in early stages of condensation. The chromatid and chromonemata are 2 names for the same structure, a single linear DNA molecule with its associated proteins. The chromonemata form the gene-bearing portions of the chromosomes, although each chromonema may contain non-genic materials that serve to maintain its integrity. The chromonemata are embedded in a proteinaceous substance called matrix. Both chromonemati remain intimately coiled in a spiral manner with each other and have a series of microscopically visible bead-like swellings along its length called chromomeres. Now the chromomeres. Chromomeres are bead-like bodies over the chromonemata. The regions between these chromomeres are called interchromomeres. Chromomeres are especially obvious in polytheian chromosomes, where they become aligned side by side, constituting the chromosome bands. These tightly folded regions of DNA are of considerable interest because they may correspond to the units of genetic function in the chromosome. At metaphase, the chromosome is tightly coiled and the chromosomes are no longer visible. Now, the centromere. The centromere is the constricted region where the two sister chromatids are joined in the metaphase chromosome. This is the site of assembly of the kinetochore, a protein complex which attaches to the microtubule of the mitotic spindle. The microtubules act to separate the chromatids at anaphase. The DNA of the centromere has been shown in yeast to consist merely of a short 80 rich sequences of 88 base pairs flanked by two very short conserved regions. In mammalian cells, centromeres seem to consist of rather longer sequences and are flanked by a larger quantity of repeated DNA known as satellite DNA. The number and position of centromere is variable but is definite in a specific chromosome of all the cells and in all the individuals of the same species. Thus, according to the number of the centromere, the eukaryotic chromosomes may be eccentric without any centromere, monocentric with one centromere, dicentric with two centromeres, or polycentric with more than two centromeres. The centromere has small granules or spherules and divides the chromosome into two or more equal or unequal chromosomal arms. A chromosome may be characterized by its total length and the position of the centromere. The position of centromere varies from chromosome to chromosome and it provides following different shapes to the chromosomes: telocentric, acrocentric, submetacentric and metacentric. First, the telocentric. When the centromere is at the terminal position, the chromosome is called telocentric. The chromosomes are rod-shaped. Telocentric chromosomes are very rare. In telocentric chromosomes, one arm is very long and other is very short. The short chromosome arm is designated P, means P-tight, and the long arm is designated as Q, one letter after P. Now, the acrocentric chromosomes. When the centromere is situated near one end, forming a long arm and a very short arm or even imperceptible short arm, and the chromosome appears rod-shaped. Now, the submetacentric chromosomes. When the centromere is situated slightly away from the middle and one arm of the chromosome will be shorter than the other, such a chromosome will appear L-shaped during anaphasic moment. Now, the metacentric chromosomes. When the centromere lies at or near the middle of the chromosome and the two arms of the chromosome are almost equal, then it is called metacentric. During anaphasic moment, the chromosomes bend at the centromere so that the metacentric chromosomes are V-shaped. Now, the telomere. Telomeres are the specialized structures at the ends of linear DNA molecules of eukaryotes. The telomeres hide the ends of the chromosome from the mechanisms within the cell that monitor DNA damage. They are also needed to overcome the problem of end replication. Most eukaryotes overcome the end replication problem with an enzyme called telomerase, a ribonucleoprotein that uses its own RNA template to add on simple repeats to the 3' ends of chromosomes, elongating them. A telomere consisting of up to hundreds of copies of a repeated sequence of 5', TTA, GGG, 3' in humans, which is synthesized by enzyme telomerase. The telomeres of Drosophila melanogaster are unusual in that mobile repetitive sequences are found at the ends of the chromosomes rather than tandem repeats of TTA, GGG. Telomerase activity is highest in the germline cells. Somatic cells have little telomerase and they have shorter telomeres than cells of the germline. It is estimated that 50 to 200 base pairs of DNA is lost from the end of the chromosome per cell division in the absence of telomerase activity. Telomere length also decreases with age, and this has led to speculation that telomere shortening may play some role in aging. Centromeres and telomeres are two essential features of all eukaryotic chromosomes. Each provides a unique function that is absolutely necessary for the stability of the chromosome. Centromeres are required for the segregation of chromosomes during meiosis and mitosis, and telomeres provide terminal stability to the chromosomes and ensure its survival. Now, secondary constriction. Sometimes a chromosome may have an additional constriction apart from the centromere called secondary constriction. Secondary constriction mark the location at which nucleoli are assembled. The chromosomes possess secondary constriction at any point. These secondary constrictions, they contain the genes coding for 18S and 28S ribosomal RNA and induce the formation of nucleoli. It is often associated with the nucleolus during interphase and may take part in the reorganization of the nucleolus at the end of cell division, and because of this region, secondary constriction may also be called a nucleolus organizing region. Now, the satellite bodies. The part of the chromosome which is present beyond the secondary constriction is called the satellite body. Satellite body appears as rounded or knob-like appendage and varies in size according to the position of the secondary constriction. The satellites remain connected with the rest of the chromosome by a thin chromatin filament. Chromosomes bearing satellites are called sat chromosomes. Chromosome satellites are a morphological entity. They should not be confused with satellite DNA, which are the highly repeated DNA sequences. Chemical composition of chromosomes. The chromosomes are generally composed of chromatin, a complex of DNA and protein. A significant amount of RNA is also associated with chromosomes because chromosomes are the sites of RNA synthesis. The proteins are of two major classes, histones and non-histone proteins. Histones are very basic proteins. Being basic, histones bind tightly to DNA, which is acidic. As many as five histones are found in the chromosomes, namely H1, H2A, H2B, H3, and H4. The non-histone protein fraction of the chromatin consists of a large number of very heterogeneous proteins. The non-histone proteins are mostly acidic and have been considered more important than histones as regulatory molecule. Some non-histone proteins also have enzymatic activities. The most enzymatic proteins of chromosomes are phosphoproteins, DNA polymerase, RNA polymerase, DPN pyrophosphorylase, and nucleoside triphosphatase. The metal ions such as calcium and magnesium are supposed to maintain the organization of chromosomes intact. In spermatozoa of fishes, protoamines are found. The protoamines are low molecular weight basic proteins rich in the amino acid arginine, the karyotype. The name karyotype is given to the whole group of characteristics that allow the identification of a particular chromosome set, that is, the number of chromosomes, relative size, position of the centromere, length of the arms, secondary constructions, and satellites. It is characteristic of an individual, species, genus, or larger grouping and may be represented by a diagram called karyogram or ideogram. Generally, in an ideogram, the chromosomes of a haploid set of an organism are ordered in a series of decreasing order. Sometimes an ideogram is prepared for the diploid set of chromosomes in which the pairs of homologies are ordered in a series of decreasing order. Some species may have special characteristics. For example, The mouse has acrocentric chromosomes. Many amphibians have only metacentric chromosomes, and plants frequently have heterochromatic regions at the telomeres. The karyotypes can be used for many purposes, for example, to study chromosomal aberrations, cellular function, taxonomic relationships, and to gather information about evolutionary events. Special types of chromosomes. The eukaryotes, besides possessing the usual type of chromosomes in their body cells, contain some unusual and special types of chromosomes in some body cells or at some particular stage of their life cycle. The special types of chromosomes are number 1, Lambert chromosomes, number 2, Palatine chromosomes, and number 3, B chromosomes. First, the Lambert chromosomes. These chromosomes occur in the oocytes of amphibians and in some insects. They are extremely large, synapsed homologous chromosomes, which can be seen in the diploid stage of prophase first in meiosis. They measure about 1500 to 2000 micrometer in length. The Lambert chromosomes were discovered by Ruckert in 1892. They are formed during the active synthesis of messenger RNA molecules for the future use by the egg during cleavage. When no synthesis of mRNA molecules is possible due to active involvement of chromosomes in the mitotic cell division. A Lambert chromosome consists of an axis from which paired loops extend in all directions. During the appearance of a Lambert, the axis consists of chromomeres and interchromomere regions. The loops consist of transcriptionally active DNA, which can synthesize large amount of mRNA necessary for the synthesis of yolk. Number 2, Palatine chromosomes are salivary gland chromosomes. These are giant chromosomes found in the salivary glands of Drosophila and Chironomus. These were first observed by E.G. Balbiani, an Italian cytologist, in 1881. In the salivary glands of Chironomus, and hence are called salivary gland chromosomes. They are many times larger than the normal chromosomes, reaching a length of 2000 micrometer, and are visible even under a compound microscope. The Palatine chromosomes of the salivary gland cells of Drosophila melanogaster are formed by 9 or 10 consecutive multiplication cycles and remain associated parallel to each other. Further, the Palatine chromosomes have alternating dark and light bands along their length. The dark bands are comparable with the chromomeres of simple chromosomes and are disc-shaped structures occupying the whole diameter of chromosomes. They contain euchromatin. The light bands are or interbands are fibrillar and composed of heterochromatin. An interesting characteristic of the Palatine chromosomes is the presence of specific sites showing local enlargements called chromosomal puffs or Balbiani rings. They are associated with differential gene activation. In a puff, the DNA molecule unfolds into open loops due to intense transcription. Puffing is a cyclic and irreversible phenomenon. Some bands do not puff at all, whereas others do. Puffing may occur before, during, or sometimes after molting. Number 3, the B chromosomes. Many plant and animal species, besides having autosomes and sex chromosomes, possesses a special category of chromosomes called B chromosomes without obvious genetic function. These B chromosomes, also called supernumerary chromosomes, accessory chromosomes, or accessory fragments, usually have a normal structure or somewhat smaller than the autosomes and can be predominantly heterochromatic, for example, in many insects, maize, etc., or predominantly euchromatic, for example, in case of rye. In maize, their number, per cell may reach up to 30, and they adversely affect development and fertility only when occur in large amount. In animals, the B chromosomes disappear from the non-reproductive tissue and are maintained only in the cell lines that led to the reproductive organs. B chromosomes have negative consequences for the organisms as they have deleterious effect because of abnormal crossing over during the meiosis of animals and abnormal nuclear divisions of the gametophyte plants. In animals, B chromosomes occur more frequently in females and the basis is non-disjunction. The non-disjunction of B chromosomes of the ripe plant is found to be caused due to the presence of a heterochromatic knob at the end of long arm of B chromosome. The significance of chromosomes. Chromosomes are the hereditary vehicles carrying genes from parents to offspring. Chromosomes are the essential units for cellular division and must be replicated, divided, and passed successfully to their daughter cells so as to ensure the genetic diversity and survival of their progeny. Chromosomal recombination plays a vital role in genetic diversity. The chromosomes control metabolism and also all other activities of cell by directing synthesis of required enzymatic proteins. These bring about continuity of life by replication. Nucleolus formation is controlled by the nucleolar organized region of certain chromosomes. The chromosomes play important role in sex determination. These undergo mutations and contribute to evolution in all living organisms. Dear students, this is all about morphology of chromosomes.